Hey guys, welcome back to another video. It's your boy Lenny Bukley, Jeff, and here again. Super excited to have you back in yet another video. In today's video, we're talking about YouTube setups. Now, in today's video, like I said, I'm going to be talking about setups, and I'm going to break down the setups that I have used over time that have worked for me. And then I'll tell you the setups that I recommend depending on whatever your budget is. And then finally, we'll conclude the conversation by talking about, you know, gear doesn't matter, you know, all this ramble about gear doesn't matter. We'll conclude the conversation with that. All right, first of all, when I first started YouTube, the setup I would always use was my Tecno Camon X and my Windows. That was all there was to the setup because I did not have a budget. So if, I think I can just alternate these two conversations about what I would recommend depending on your budget. So if you do not have a budget and you're looking to start YouTube, the best setup to use is your window for lighting and your smartphone for capturing the video, because smartphones are great. I've always said that. And the lights from the sun, daylight is usually almost always the best light to use because it's the cleanest light you can get. But it comes with its caveats, which is why people now go for artificial lighting, which will come to later in the video. But if you're starting out and you have little or no budget, then your best option, your best bet, you start with your smartphone and then use your window for lighting. So moving on, the next setup I moved to was this one you're seeing on the screen right now. At this time, I was working with a company and I would usually rent gear. So whenever I rented gear, I would just keep the gear and then film my videos very early in the morning. I think I filmed about 2 videos with this gear. I used, in these videos, I used the Canon 7D Mark II and an LED panel light. Some of these normal LEDs, a Godox LED panel light. Now, for those, I think that worked. You could see that the quality of the videos were great. The lighting was also fantastic. So you could see the difference in the videos. Now, this moves me to talk about audio. I've talked about capturing video and I've talked about lighting, but I haven't talked about audio. The most part of my early YouTube journey, I used this very cheap lav mic. This one I'm using right now is a more expensive one, but it was a very cheap lav mic. I think it was like 10 or 20 bucks. The audio quality wasn't the best, but it worked. It was able to streamline the sound to my voice. And so I used a lav mic on that camera. Now, the challenge with that is that I usually do not advise that you use a lav mic on a camera, like directly from a camera, especially if it's not an expensive one. I don't know what the audio is going to be like. So what I would advise is that you get like a smartphone, plug in your lav mic, it records separately, and then tidy up, you know, merge everything, synchronize everything in editing, which we'll come to later in the video. But for now, what I would say is, depending on your budget, if you want to rent gear, renting gear could cost you between 10 to 15,000 naira per rentage per day. So if you said that you want to shoot once every week, well, you can do the math yourself. I don't want to start getting into all of that. But if you do not have that kind of budget, the best thing to do is to go with your smartphone. Now, something I just remembered about using the smartphone is that a lot of smartphones these days are coming out without 3.5mm headphone jacks, headphone ports, and standard. Even the phone I'm using right now is a, and I'll get to that when I get to the setup, but the phone I'm using right now is a Google Pixel 2 XL, and it does not have a microphone, an earpiece port, that 3.5mm headphone jack. So I have to record on a separate phone. However, I'm sure that there are adapters that you can use to adapt your Type-C or your Lightning port for the iPhones to the 3.5mm. At least I have seen for the Lightning. I've not seen for a Type-C before, but I'm sure that it exists for the Lightning, and you know, you'll be fine with that. Now, moving on to the next setup I used, and I think I used this one for the longest. I used the window for the longest, then moved to this one for a very long period of time. I was using a very small table lamp in my house. Now, Nigeria is a very noisy place. Everybody knows that. So that was the reason I stopped shooting with the window, because the window was only available in the daytime, and the daytime was very noisy. Actually, during the COVID lockdown, everybody was at home. So the only time I could film was at night, and then I had to find a way to light the videos. And then I found a table lamp in the house. It's not in the house. I think somebody took it out, so I would have shown it in the video. But yeah, it was a very small table lamp with a regular bulb, and I would just place it and find it. I was just alternating the angles. I use it in a lot of videos. So I was just alternating. It was quite dark, but at least it was doing the job of lighting my face, and that was, I was satisfied with that for the period of time. Over time, the phones I have used to film my videos have changed. I've used a Canon X, which is what I started with. Then I've used an iPhone 6. Then I've used a Xiaomi Redmi Note 8. So it depends on, you know, what you have available, and I'll get to that conversation also at the end of the video. Now, coming back to the conversation of audio, what a lot of people don't know is that for a very large part of my YouTube career, I did not have a mic. Yes, audio is very important, so you have to pay attention to the audio you're putting out. I have one video on the channel I refused to take down because one of my highest viewed videos, but the audio on that video was absolute trash and it hurts me a lot, but I like to keep it there to look at it so I can remind myself not to ever make that kind of mistake ever again. But still, audio is very important when it comes to making YouTube videos. So what am I getting at? Well, for a large part of my YouTube journey, I did not have a mic. At the beginning, I had the cheap lav mic I talked about, but that one got damaged because, of course, it's a cheap lav mic. It's going to get damaged. It got damaged and I could not use it anymore. So what was I using? My audio was good for that long. What was I using? Well, I'll never advise anybody to use the audio coming directly from their phone. Like, the built-in audio is never going to work. Nigeria is a noisy place, especially if you live in a noisy environment like I do. The audio from your phone is not going to be your best bet ever. So, yes, what was I using? I was using earphones, actually. The microphone from earphones do magic. Like, you cannot even imagine. It blew my mind when I realized how much you can do with the microphone that is fitted in earphones. If you buy a really good earphone that has a really good mic, I'm certain that you get good audio from it. So it just depends on your budget. If you have a little more to spend on audio, you can buy lav mics like Dex that could cost you like $40 or $50 or $60. It just depends on your budget. Let's now kick it up a notch. After that period of time that I was shooting that, and I moved working with my friend at his office, and then I was using his gear to shoot. Now, then I was taking video with the Panasonic G7. I've already talked about it on the channel before. And for lighting, I used the Godox SL60W, and for audio, I used the Samsung Q2U. Now, all of these are great gear, but all of them fall in a mid-range budget. So far, I've been talking about low budget, you know, sunlight, small lamps, smartphones, all of that. So now we're looking at, if you have a little money to spend, you can even fit a camera and a good light with a lav mic and you'll be fine also. It just depends on how much you have to spend and you have to prioritize. But I'll also get to that at the end of the video. So much to talk about at the end of the video, but we get that. So yes, it depends on what you can afford at a particular time. So all of this is if you have a little money to spend, like a mid-range budget. You have the Panasonic G7. It's not the best camera in the world, but it offers great stuff. It offers you 4K, offers you, you know, all that, which is good. The one thing you have to note if you decide to go for that camera is that you will suffer with autofocus. I remember a couple of videos I shot, and after doing the whole thing, I realized that my face was not in focus and all the videos were useless. So you have to take note of that if you're going for that camera. If you have a little more money to spend in the mid-range budget, I feel a little more to spend like 200 times, but if you have a little more money to spend in the mid-range budget, you can go for the Canon M50 or the Sony A6000. These both are great cameras. All three are great cameras, although some do better than others in different categories. I've already done a video comparing the three of them, so I'll link that here so you can check that out after this video. The final category we are going to talk about is editing. Now, when it comes to editing, some people make use of their phones, but that's something I can never do personally. I have I don't know what to call it, pride or taste or whatever, but I can never edit with my phone. It's not something I can do or will ever do, hopefully. I've always edited from my PC because I am more comfortable editing with that. There are a lot of great apps that the Play Store offers and the App Store offers that you can use to edit videos, but I feel like they are usually very limited. It's either they give you watermarks or they crop the videos, or they kill the quality of the videos, and I really cannot deal with that because of my taste and the kind of work that I do. But when it comes to editing with your PC, you don't have to be too scared that your PC has to be the best in the world. What you can have, a laptop that is not too old, something between 2015 till now should still work for you. And if you have good RAM, like 4 gigs of RAM, and you have enough space, right? You should be fine. Although I might not advise you to use Premiere Pro, I've already talked about a beginner editor that I think can work for anybody. I'll leave the video also linked here and in the description down below. So I might not advise you to use Premiere Pro because Premiere Pro is hectic and it might take you time to learn. Now, finally, before we go, I want to conclude. I want to talk about buying gear. First of all, I'll just go ahead to say that you should not try to buy all the gear at once. It will overwhelm you, it will make you feel under-motivated. So what I would advise is for you to buy gradually. Start with your audio once you get your audio sorted, because that's like really the most important part. So depending on what you started with, you can start with your audio, buy your audio gear, whether it's a lav mic or a podcast mic or a dynamic mic like the Samsung Q2U, or if you have extreme money to spend, you can buy one of the Shure mics or those pro level mics. And then after your audio, move into lighting, because that's the next most important part. Getting good lighting, get a good lighting setup, some background lighting, some, you know, just lighting that will make your videos pop even more. Then after that, get a laptop, get something good for editing. If it's a laptop, if you decide to build a PC, whatever you think works for you, whatever works for the budget you have, but make sure you start with editing. Because if you buy, and then before you buy a camera or whatever, because if you buy a camera before you buy a good laptop, you would not have a laptop to edit the footage from those cameras. So keep that in mind when you buy. Now, finally, let's talk about gear. Doesn't matter. Personally, for my title, you can see that I've said that gear matters. But gear, it depends on the context. Gear doesn't matter if you are really interested in creating content. Right now, I'm making use of a lav mic, a very small softbox from Mount Dog, and in an LED corn light on my Pixel 2 XL. That's all that's in this setup. I have something to just make the background look nice. It's my monitor, Septa monitor, and the RGB lighting fitted behind it. So it just depends on what you have available. Over time, what I have always stuck to is what I have available to film. If I do not have the big gear available, I will go with what I have. So if you have the money to buy better gear, I would advise you to buy better gear, because I promise you that you'll be satisfied with the result of those things. I mean, I know how much satisfaction I always felt from when I was using the SL60W and the G7, but it doesn't mean I will stop creating content because I don't have access to those anymore. I'm going to keep creating content until I can get my gear to that level. Well, guys, that brings us to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed watching. I hope you learned a thing or two. I hope you're going to apply. Let me know what setup you have enjoyed the most from my channel. I have gone through a lot of setups. Let me know in the comment section down below. Please smash a like on the video, subscribe to the channel. You know the drill, hit the bell to turn on notifications so that you see more of my videos in the future. And I guess I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.